The sixth episode of Power Rangers Beast Morphers, Hangar Heist. This is a bit of an interesting episode. A lot of it centered around the conflict between Devon and Ravi, but not in a way that I would have expected. I mean, the episode picks up in the aftermath of the previous episode, where they have their secret hangar in the forest, and a captured Gigadrone that they're trying to reverse engineer. And one piece of technology taken from the Gigadrone, Nate says Grid Battle Force will be able to use it to predict when an enemy Gigadrone will be teleporting in. So it's not a total surprise when it pops up in the battlefield. But that hasn't been put into use yet. But he does let Devon borrow a bit of Morphex, because he and the other Rangers, along with Ben and Betty, have made up some model rockets and they're just launching out of Morphex. See how well they perform. Unfortunately, for some reason, we never see Zoe with one. And Ravi's looks really nice, and it goes straight up with no issues. Ben and Betty's, however, does unlock right away, so they tug at the cord and it lopsides a little bit, and so when it does activate, it flies around and chases them around and goes crashing somewhere. And they're really freaked out because that belonged to their father. You know, the commander that granted them that hangar to begin with. So the two of them run off to go find it. Then we have Devon's rocket, which looks a lot more like Diddy's guitar from Donkey Kong 64. Ravi says, "Are you sure it's gonna work? It don't look like your stabilizer fins are in the right place." Devon's like, "Yeah, it's fine. I did plenty of this in Rocket Sim." Little does our Red Ranger know that simulation is not a perfect predictor for reality. For when his rocket goes up, it tumbles in air and crashes into the ground and breaks apart. Now, Devon believes he did no wrong. He believes that one of the parts he ordered to make it was defective. But Ravi tries to tell him, he's like, "No, man, I'm pretty sure it was the..." And he just cuts him off, he says, to just lay off it. And he walks off. Now, back at Grid Battle Force, they are in a high-end simulation of testing putting all the Zords together to finally make the Beast X Megazord. However, they fail. Ravi suggests putting up the shields during the combination sequence, but Devon says no, the enemy's about to attack, we'll hit it first and then do the combination. Unfortunately, they get hit again doing it and it screws up the combination and the simulation fails. And Devon, not even given a moment to try again, just storms off angry. To which Commander Shaw stops him in the hall and asks him what his problem is. And he's saying that Ravi's out of line and his instincts have never been wrong. And that was his instincts that gave him the idea to, you know, collect the Gigadrone parts to begin with. And Shaw really goes into him. She tells him, "Yes, you have good instincts and you should trust in them, but you also need to trust in your teammates. Because even a good leader can make bad decisions." She even tells him that he's better than the way he acted. And I agree, this seems very out of character for him, but I'll get to that towards the end of this review. Now back outside in the wilderness, Ben and Betty do find their rocket, which end up flying all the way getting caught in the net close to where the hangar was. Unfortunately, they see Roxy's avatar there as well, because Evox has ordered both her and Scrozzle to go stop that operation because the Rangers are smart. They can take the data from the Gigadrone and use it against them. Alright, this would like to see acts of espionage against both sides. Or is it just sabotage? Anyway, the twins contact the commander and instruct her to get the Rangers. Of course, Roxy sees them and shoots the one engine of the rocket that didn't get activated. And so they end up getting blasted away, being carried off by the rocket. Ah, those poor, stupid brother and sister. I still find them to be more endearing than Victor and Monty, just saying. Because at least they're actually friendly and going out of their way to try and be helpful to the Rangers. So they are kind of good-spirited comic relief. Now, back onto more pressing matters. Grozzle has sent along a Robotron named Meltatron, based off a container of acid, so it can just burn through materials, including the entrance to the hangar. And so the Rangers, Roxy, and Meltatron have a really close quarters battle inside a hangar, but not before Roxy gets some energy to reboot the Slicetron Gigadrone. And of course, to take it a step further, she starts to seal them in so they'll be trapped with the Gigadrone. But Ravi gets a quick plan. He takes Devon and throws him out the door just before it shuts on him. And he contacts him to trust what he's doing. He can help from the outside. Use the Racer Zord to open the hatch and to hurry. So inside the hangar, the two of them are fighting. And now while they're all fighting in the hangar, Scrozzle just sees a bunch of machine parts. He says, "Oh, let's do shopping." And by that I mean he just steals a bunch of crap. But one thing stands out is his really unique looking robot head that's in perfect condition. It definitely didn't come from any of his creations, but he takes it all the same. And when Meltatron's main weapon gets broken, they just use the Beast X blasters to finish him off, and Scrozzle makes his retreat. But halfway through that fight, Roxy notices that one of the Rangers is missing, so she orders Scrozzle to make a Giga Drone to stop the Red Ranger. Unfortunately, this is just what he could have used, because he wrestles with that Giga Drone, based off of Meltatron, of course, and it just grabs the acid spray and uses it to melt the hatch of the hangar. To which the other two Rangers jump out and get into their Zords, because the Slicer Drone is reactivated. So now they have two to fight at the same time. Obviously, that's too much firepower for them to face the individual Zords, so they decide this time they'll do it right and they'll make the Megazord. And Devon listens to Ravi this time and activates the shields, and this protects them against the incoming attacks just long enough to form the Beast X Megazord, which is more like the Racer Zord with the other parts making armor and weaponry on the edges of it. We don't see much of it in action. I mean, one arm of it is sort of like a claw, and it just nullified missile attacks from the Slicer Drone. And the other is a saber, not a big sword, but it's powered by Morphex, to the point where you can actually see the Morphex and its energy charging up to the center of it. And it's just one slash through that just destroys them inside of a bubble that gets them trapped. Oh, and this trap was made from the armor pieces that were from Ravi's Zord. It just lights around the legs and the chest and just traps them in the bubble, so there's no way they can avoid the finishing strike. Pretty unique on the details, but the finishing blow does seem like just a little bit underwhelming. But overall, nothing major. Now back in the Cyber Dimension, I found out that's what it's supposed to be called, not Dimension X, Evox is scolding the Avatars for letting them destroy another drone, but they defend themselves and say that they stopped the Rangers from getting more data out of it. Unfortunately, they wasted a ton of Morphex, where Scrozzle says he found something for Evox to help build that thing that they talked about. What that thing is, we don't know. It's kept a secret from us, the audience, as well. And Avatars start trying to fight Scrozzle, but Evox intervenes and says that he'll have them turned into Tronics if they screw up again. So our villains have something big planned that's more than just trying to get more Morphex and power up their Robotrons and such. And now we have a nice aftermath who doesn't end with Ben and Betty being screwed over. Mainly because they kinda did it early in the episode. Instead they're brought back into the clearing, where they've launched rockets before, but they're blindfolded, and when they're taken off, it's shown that Ravi and Devon had remade the rocket together. And Devon listens to what he's saying. And so they launch it up and it goes straight up, with no problems whatsoever, and that's how the episode ends. Now this was a good episode. I mean, Ben and Betty played a bigger part than they did in the last time, where they're seen as nothing. This time they were somewhat integrated into the actual plot of the episode, and actually helped the Rangers get the jump on the enemy before they were too late. Plus, we get to see more dynamic between the villains, and also building up suspense to what disaster they can bring next time, instead of just an idle threat that they're just going to attack again. Because we know they will, or we wouldn't have a show without that. But what really made this episode weird to me was the conflict between Devon and Ravi. I really expected this to happen the other way around, where Devon would be very calm and Ravi would be getting agitated. Since we've seen in the first episode that Devon's laid-back personality can cause some conflict with others. This time it's the other way around. This is out of character for Devon because he's just so easily agitated. I mean, this would have worked a few episodes ago, maybe like episode 3. Before he made a close connection with the team, especially after the previous episode where the Rangers went out of their way to help him with his own problem. They've proven themselves to be reliable. Plus, he's worked together to finish enemies with help from them before. Though he does realize and apologize to Ravi after he launched that rocket at the end. But still, I think it's just a little late for him to learning to trust and respect his team after they've gone through several events together. Of course, I get it, they have to make it work with the Sentai footage, but they could have found another way to show an interpersonal conflict. This seems like they thought of it a little too late, and so they tried to make it, like, extremely abrasive the way Devon acts. And really, it just seemed completely confusing to see him react that way. I mean, he is the younger, so I guess he is the least mature. Still, it just did not quite sit right with me, the way they handled this. I mean, overall, the episode was great, but that one aspect of it, even though it was two short little scenes, really just made me think of that they just threw it in there so that they'd have some sort of conflict that's beyond the monster of the week, and didn't put quite as much care into it as they have in the previous episodes. Because the instant Ravi just takes charge and throws Devon out that room and tells him his plan, Devon doesn't hesitate. Once he gets what Ravi is trying to tell him, he just runs out and gets to it and works on that exact plan, no hesitation whatsoever. So this is very shortly after his talk with Commander Shaw. And I guess he's calmed down from earlier, and he's probably taking some time off screen to reflect on that. Plus, they're in the middle of battle, he don't even have any choice, but still. I feel like they just shoehorned that issue in there because they couldn't think of any other way to have them separated for half the episode. But anyway, I'm looking forward to the things that are coming. How they predict where the Giga Drone is going to teleport, as well as what Skrozzo and Evox are up to. It's going to be an interesting development indeed. So overall, this episode gets a B instead of an A. But it's still a very good track record for this season so far. So I would not recommend skipping it. Well, that's my thoughts on the episode. If you think it's different, or am I giving it too high a praise, or maybe I'm just seeing too much negative with it, why don't you let me know in the comments. Until then, thanks for watching, it's been Jargus, and I'll see you for episode 7. Let the power protect you.